In this video, I will be talking about the movie Arrival, released in 2016, directed by Denis Villeneuve, starring Amy Adams and Jeremy Renner. Before you watch this video, I just want to say that it contains a lot of spoilers. If you haven't watched the movie, pause the video, watch the movie and come back.
Pick him up!
Are you the sheriff in this here town? My tickle guns.
The movie opens with Louise joyfully playing with her daughter, but within a few moments we see that her daughter, who was once joyfully playing with her mother, has a life-threatening condition that ends her life at a very young age.
Baby, come back to me.
And the screen fades to black. A few minutes later, we see that extraterrestrial creatures have arrived in their pods to the Earth. Because there are several pods that have landed on Earth, each country attempts to communicate with the aliens. Humans want to know why they are here and what they want. So in America, they call Louise. Louise is a linguistics expert who is called in by the American military to help understand what the extraterrestrial creatures might communicate with them. Louise is deployed with a theoretical physicist, Ian Donnelly, and they are both expected by the military to decipher the complexity of the language and try to understand why the aliens are on Earth. As Louise interacts with the aliens, she starts having flashbacks of her daughter. The more she interacts with and understands the language of the extraterrestrials, the more she keeps having these flashbacks.
That's like, the Earth is a planet.
Want to see my project for Miss Garriott's class?
Yeah, little nose.
We had to make up our own TV show. If we had one.
And who are those two people?
That's you and Dad. The show was called Mommy and Daddy Talk to Animals.
No, it's lovely.
Ian Donnelly, who has been working closely with Louise for months, falls in love with her.
I guess that's why I'm single.
Trust me, you can understand communication and still end up single.
Everyone's desperation to understand the intentions of aliens fades away when aliens tell them the word weapon.
What does it say?
Offer weapon.
Use weapon. This is the alien message said to have provoked the Chinese government to withdraw their scientists from the international mission today. In a statement, General Shang said, China no longer trusts the aliens who want to divide us. Humanity must be protected.
Tonight, China becomes the first world power to declare war against the aliens.
But Louise understands why the aliens are actually here. The weapon the aliens wanted to offer was a language that lets us know the future and the past. We discover that the creatures from the outside world perceive time differently, seeing the past, present, and future as a whole rather than linearly. The key to understanding their perception of time is to understand their language, which is a way of knowing the future and the past. Louise at the end stops the war after learning the aliens' language by calling the Chinese General Shang, who was going to lead the war. Louise calls and tells him something that stops the war. And months later, there's a meeting in which the Chinese leader General Shang and Louise are present. General Shang approaches Louise and tells her that he couldn't believe it when she told him his wife's last words on the phone. Louise knew the last words of his wife because she knew the past. The part that was most disagreeable for me was this. Louise's visions while interacting with aliens were of her future, not her past. The child she was seeing in her flashbacks was from her future, which she is going to have with her husband, Ian Donnelly, the theoretical physicist. Louise knew her child would suffer and die at a young age, yet she decided to have the child. Why? Is it because of Louise's love for her daughter? Is she willing to endure the pain of knowing she will eventually lose her at such a young age? Or is it to experience the fulfillment of being a parent? Does the relationship's meaning and love outweigh the child's suffering? Or is Louise optimistically biased?
Despite knowing the journey and where it leads, I embrace it. And I welcome every moment of it.
When Louise had every reason to avoid a lot of pain, she chose to have the child. I understand that it is hard not to bring someone when we know exactly how they will look and be with us. But must we not avoid having children whom we know will inevitably go through a lot of pain? Movies like this make me want to ask more questions. The answers the writer or the director wants me to have are often not the answers that I agree with.
Believe it or not, I know something that's going to happen. I can't explain how I know, I just do. And when I told your daddy, he got really mad. And he said I made the wrong choice.
What? What's going to happen?
It has to do with a really rare disease. And it's unstoppable. Kind of like you are. You're swimming. And your poetry and all the other amazing things that you share with the world.
I am unstoppable.